Yeah. So we come here last time, and we were treated with a lot of respect. But we only come to audit the building. We didn't actually come to audit anything in particular. So what we're doing now is, we're auditing, we're reporting on Robert Hannigan. He was in charge of Britain's surveillance agency for just over 2 years. His resignation in 2017 came out of the blue and surprised security observers. Hannigan, then 51, said he wanted to prioritise his family, but in actuality, he wanted to prioritise GCHQ. If he wanted to prioritise his family, then he wouldn't have been involved with a paedophile priest, would he? What he wanted to do was protect the reputation of GCHQ from being involved in a paedophile ring. But that's all too late now. Because now GCHQ is the snapshot. Anyway. So, Robert Hannigan, director of GCHQ, resigned with the blessing of Theresa May so that GCHQ wouldn't take the brunt of a paedophile being in charge of the entire operation. Having connections with the third most powerful Catholic lay in the UK, Edmund Higgins, now Edmund Black, changed his name after he pled guilty to charges involving child abuse images. The court heard that the former priest would watch and share child abuse videos, including one that involved a baby. Well, this is what our public money is paying for, is for the people that should be saving the children are actually abusing the children. And then they are covering up every single crime. Every single bit of evidence they are covering up with their security specialization. It was during a National Crime Agency investigation into online chat rooms that Priest Higgins and his links to Hannigan were discovered. It was an investigation into online chat rooms that involved children being abused that Higgins and his links to Hannigan were discovered. So Hannigan is trying to say that the only way he knows this priest is as a family friend, but the only reason links were found to each other was through the same online chat rooms that they used to watch children being abused, including a baby being abused. The media was told that his resignation was mainly for family health reasons. So I'll say it a different way. The media was told to inform the public that his resignation was mainly for family health reasons. Hannigan reportedly offered to resign to avoid dragging GCHQ into a scandal and did so with Theresa May's blessing. God forbid she ever gets back into power. The same woman that said we were getting too old, we were collecting our pensions. And what was it? We want to stop getting cremated because there's no crude oil that can be pulled out of ashes, isn't it? You know? Obviously the reason. Anyway, his subsequent criminal actions appalled us and have shown us that our judgment was completely wrong. When I later become director of GCHQ, all the correct steps were taken in relation to my involvement in this case. And this was verified by government lawyers. Well, you know what? Generally, you only get a lawyer if you're guilty. You know, if you're telling the truth, you don't even need a lawyer, you know, because the truth speaks for itself. This is a personal family matter. See, this is what he says, right? He says, this is a personal family matter. What? Was the whole family involved in paedophilia? Because this is about paedophilia, nothing to do with his family.
It's a cover-up, it's so he can get away with it.
Yeah, it's a cover-up so he can get away with it. So the whole organisation can get away with it. While at GCHQ, Hannigan led a push to make the agency more transparent. And then Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson praised him for setting up the groundwork for the transformation of Britain's cyber defences. Now, when Hannigan told the newspaper that Higgins had been a close family friend for 20 years, after they pleaded guilty to child sexual imagery offences in 2013, we submitted a character reference on our knowledge of him to the court in good faith. And then what happened there was the court gave him a suspended sentence for child paedophilia. And then after that, he continued to reoffend. But I am losing my shit all of the time. So when he did finally get the go-ahead off Theresa May to resign, this is what he said. He said, in his resignation letter, he said, his 20-year career as a public servant had demanded a great deal of my ever patient and understanding family, and is now the right time for a change in direction. It seems funny how it goes hand in hand with being done for paedophilia and involvement with paedophilia, that he should just decide out of the blue that his family can't cope with things. You know, his family could cope with 20 years of him having a paedophile coming in and out of his house. You know, it's as simple as it gets. And if this is the head of security, you know, if anybody was going to know that a priest was a paedophile, it would be the head of the highest security company in the entire of the UK. You know, that's in cyber security GCHQ deals with. And ironically, it wasn't GCHQ that found out about the paedophilia going on online chat rooms. It was some other place, nothing to do with GCHQ. The National Crime Agency, so that's possibly, who found out.
GCHQ possibly would have let it continue to happen.
GCHQ allowed it to continue for a long time. Now I got a bit more in here about GCHQ. Let me get onto this little page.
You want to move down there? Continue?
No. So here's another one we should look at. So, one of Britain's most influential paedophiles was the head of a Masonic lodge founded and frequented by GCHQ spies. Keith Harden, former membership secretary of the Paedophile Information Exchange, PI, was made worshipful master of the Mercurius Lodge in Cheltenham, Gloucestershire in 2011. So well before any of this, they had the worshipful master of the Mercurius Lodge in Cheltenham setting up a paedophile ring in conjunction with GCHQ. So this has been going on a long time. They might blame Robert Hannigan, right? But actually, GCHQ's involvement with paedophilia has gone on for years. The child molester who died last summer presided over ceremonies and rituals from an ornate throne. Harden was convicted of an indecent assault against four children aged 8 and 9 in 1958 and classified as Schedule 1 offender, which meant the offence remained on his criminal record all of his life. His name was also on a list of about 400 PI members, that's paedophiles, seized by police in 1984. So he's already been known for it for a long time, but GCHQ actually employs paedophiles. And they don't really care, because you know the thing about employing paedophiles in GCHQ, they can use them as spies to get into rings and that. That's why they employ gangsters and terrorists as well. So they just use them for spies left, right and centre. But maybe they became a bit, what's the word, Dips? Rogue. When you become rogue and you're no longer a good person and you're now rogue.
Yeah,
so this is what I would say this organisation is. It's fully rogue. It's been rogue for a long time. Since 2011, at least, when they went hands in hands with the Mercurius Lodge, the Freemason Lodge in Cheltenham. Harden was convicted. Oh yeah, I've done that one. Blah, blah, blah. His name was on the list of about 400 paedophile members seized by police in 1984, the year the organisation disbanded. The Sunday Express revealed earlier this month how hard and Met MPs Cyril Smith and Leon Britton in the 1980s when he ran a North London antique store. 35 years ago, he appeared alongside paedophile television presenter Jimmy Savile in a Christmas special of Jimmy'll Fix It. The lodge boasts of its government communications headquarters heritage on its website. So the Freemason Lodge boasts on that they've got GCHQ in their pay pocket on its own actual website. Yeah. Yeah, they ain't even hiding it.
We're getting pictured as well.
Yeah. So we're getting pictured off this dude here. He's probably protecting paedophilia, ain't he? You know, he doesn't like it. Doesn't like it, does he? Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Anyway, I'm not scared of being videoed. I don't mind. Any paedophiles come near me, I'll twist their balls around and pull them clean out. It's as simple as it gets. Good luck being a paedophile when you can't get it up. It's as simple as it gets. You know, I got big steel toe caps on. I reckon that'd cure any paedophile. Spy agency GCHQ to be lit up as a rainbow to mark fight against homophobia.
Do you want to say this round the front? Continue this round the front so we get another shot of it.
And then
continue.
GCHQ's secret sharing with US was illegal.
Entrance. Obviously, we want somebody that works here that could maybe give us some transparency on. Does the CEO still work there? The one that gave him a little in the court went, oh yeah, he's a good guy.
I don't know. It didn't say who said it. Oh no, it was Robert Hannigan.
Yeah, I thought
that. Yeah, no, he works for the European. He's a European chairman for the cyber security Blue Voyant. Yeah. Right. So as I was saying, there's a bit more on GCHQ. The investigatory, I hate words like that. It's like Latin or something. Investigatory Powers Tribunal, which deals with GCHQ, MI5 and MI6 found intercepted communications were provided to Britain's listening post, GCHQ, in a program that, until December, breached human rights laws. However, during legal proceedings leading up to the judgment, the government revealed previously secret details of the legal framework that governs bulk interception and intelligence sharing. By doing so, it made compliant with the European Convention on Human Rights. The complicated ruling means that prior to December, the program was unlawful because the public was unaware of the safeguards in place. But since they were revealed by the hearings, the human rights violation has been addressed. Human rights groups, Liberty, Privacy International and Amnesty brought the action after US National Security Agency whistleblower Edward Snowden revealed details of surveillance programs. Yesterday's ruling has been broadly welcomed. Well, it wasn't yesterday, but this ruling was broadly welcomed by the groups, but they disagree that the safeguards revealed are sufficient to make GCHQ's intelligence sharing activities lawful. So they're still acting outside the law. They will challenge the decision at the European Court of Human Rights. Liberty's James Welch said, by keeping the public in the dark about their secret dealings with the National Security Agency, which is in America, GCHQ acted unlawfully and violated our rights. Eric King of Privacy International said, the world owes Edward Snowden a great debt. GCHQ said the ruling found against it in one small respect. Downing Street said David Cameron believes intelligence agencies should have the powers they need to keep us safe. So if I invade your privacy, I go to prison. But if I'm GCHQ, and I invade your privacy to get into your child's cell phones to see naughty little pictures and that. Well, that's okay because some MP in power seems to think it's okay that I should have the ability to ensure security, because even though well, it's not engulfing, is it? Embarking in child paedophilia, sex rings, and child abuse scandals. You know, that's okay because
they think because they're in power, right? Or have a bit of power, they can change.
They can get away with breaking the laws.
Yeah.
Human rights laws, privacy laws, child abuse laws, child paedophilia laws, paedophile rings. They think they can give out good references to paedophiles so that they avoid prison. So they don't even get 5 years as a Schedule 1 offender.
They first get let off.
Yeah, they get suspended sentence as a Schedule 1 offender. And then if they do it again, they don't even get 5 years for paedophilia.
And he formerly lived a...
Robert Hannigan, ex-head of GCHQ, paedophile friend, supporter of paedophilia, GCHQ, supporter of paedophilia, so long as it's in the Catholic Church. Would that be right? If a pagan was a paedophile, do you think they'd allow it?
Yeah, that's it. Well, see, they do, they think because they've got a lot of power, right, and they're not living in the lives that we're all living in, they can get away, oh, we don't need to go to prison, you know, no one's even going to know, all right, we can hide stuff, you know, because they have control of the media, you know, and that's very obvious.
Where is that lodge?
The lodge is in...
Albion Street.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we'll have to go there too.
Well, we can do that. We can do that at a different time.
There's another one, another paedophile. You know, there's so many paedophiles working GCHQ or have worked in GCHQ. Paedophile worked at GCHQ while we downloaded videos of child sexual abuse and filmed children in Gloucester. And no wonder Gloucester kids are mental. You know, good on them, isn't it? He walked free from court and was told to pay 20,000 quid compensation to his victims. But how many victims did he have?
Four.
What, this dude?
Yep, four.
Videos of child sexual abuse and filmed children.
There was four victims, right? Only known four victims, and he gave them five grand each.
No, he didn't. He walked out of court. This is his face here. Mark Nichols admitted his offences.
This was in 2019.
Was it?
Yeah, 3 months just before 2020.
Yeah. 22nd of November 2019.
Yep.
Mark Nichols admitted his offences.
So where is Mark Nichols now?
I don't know, we'll find out.
Because obviously
An award winning. How do people get awards here and get to director? Because it seems that everybody that gets awards and gets to director happens to be paedophiles.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's a bit strange that, isn't it? You know, there's a whole GCHQ involved with paedophilia. Is that it? Is everybody with Robert Hannigan?
I bet a couple of people were.
You're right, mate. Yeah, keep looking at me. You'll be on camera. You'll be on YouTube tonight. I take that as a threat, me, you know.
What did he say?
I don't know what he said, but he thought he'd pull his hood down and give me dirty looks at the same time. And then when I pull the camera on him, he walks away. You know what I mean? I ain't scared of you, mate. Not at all. Not at all. Anyway, so we'll get back to that. He didn't like the fact that I was saying that to get anywhere in life in GCHQ, you have to be involved with paedophilia.
Yeah, he really didn't like that.
A medal-winning GCHQ spy-based worker led a sordid secret life as a child sex offender and voyeur, filming women and a young girl in the privacy of their own homes. Mark Nichols, 39, worked at the government communications headquarters based in Cheltenham at the time when he committed the offences. It's one of the most secure buildings in the country and every role there requires in-depth security vetting. So I would say the person doing the vetting is also a paedophile, yeah, and that's why nobody. He's supporting paedophilia. Probably a mason
getting
as well.
Money. It's all about money.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway.
It's one of the most secure buildings in the country, and every role there requires in-depth security vetting. GCHQ has refused to confirm that he worked at the agency. Yeah, so they're not being transparent, are they? He was one of the few civilian intelligence workers to have been awarded the Afghanistan Medal for his services, but was caught when he took his computer for repair and indecent images of girls were found, Gloucester Crown Court was told yesterday. Police arrested Nichols and seized his computer and other equipment and found that as well as downloading images of child sexual abuse, he had also been covertly filming three women and a young girl in Quedgeley.
Wow.
Film taken through windows and from hidden locations revealed the women undressing or breastfeeding. There was also film of a naked young girl using a paddling pool in her garden. Nichols of Old Enns Lane, Stonehouse near Stroud, pleaded guilty to 5 charges of recording people doing private acts in Quedgeley, Gloucester between 2011 and 2017. So he was around for the whole time the fucking head was here, 2014 to 2017.
Same guy with
Does it?
Fines.
No, this is different. Yeah, this is £20,000 yeah. Fine.
And where's he now?
It doesn't say where he, it says. Blah, blah, blah.
Does it say former GCHQ worker?
It says Nichols of Old Enns Lane, Stonehouse near Stroud. So it doesn't say he's moved. He probably still lived there. We'll go and see him.
Yeah, he's probably.
No, he probably got protection and he thinks he doesn't have to move. He also admitted 3 charges of possession indecent images of children in 2018 and one of downloading indecent images between 2012 and 2018. What, one more in 6 years? I reckon he'd done a lot more than that. You know, coming from an ex-criminal, whatever I've been caught for is pales into insignificance compared to what I've got away with.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Finally, he admitted 3 offences of taking indecent pictures of a girl between 2012 and 2018. He also admitted 3 charges of possession indecent images of children. What?
Which YouTube channel is this then?
I don't have to tell you that, do I?
No, you don't have to tell.
I've come here a few times.
Oh, have you?
Yeah.
Oh, you Spider and Dipsy,
that's
have you?
That's the one.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the Cheltenham ones.
Yeah,
yeah. Cheltenham, okay. Cheltenham auditors, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dipsy and Spider. All right, fellas. Yeah.
We're not going to attack the place. You don't have to worry.
No, okay, mate. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, just sort of be a bit wary about filming any of the people's faces, obviously. You know, work the.
If it's in public, if you knew what we were filming for, you wouldn't even be saying that.
What? Yeah, it's not all.
We're reporting on paedophilia coming straight from GCHQ.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. You know, Robert Hannigan, he'd been done for it. Edmund Higgins, Father Edmund Higgins, was involved with it. They all covered it up. Right. Theresa May allowed them to resign as opposed to being sacked for involvement in it.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It just goes further and further back. Yeah, there's about 3 paedophiles we're reporting on now.
Yeah.
You know, and it's all different times. You know what I mean? What is this building for?
What is this building for? Well, I mean, you could Google it. It's on Wikipedia.
No, I mean,
It is for the national security.
Yeah, so shouldn't they know who works for them?
Yeah, yeah. And they do, but...
If they do...
In every walk of life, you have bad people, don't you? Do you know what I mean?
But it can't happen over and over again and not be noticed.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? They had Jimmy Savile and everything in there, involved with other paedophiles for GCHQ.
I don't think Jimmy Savile's ever been in there.
Yeah, Jimmy
anyway,
will fix
I'll
it.
I'll leave you to get on with it, mate. This is what you're going to do.
All right.
That's fine. All right, mate.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thanks, guys. You too. Right, so I'll just finish this because I was at the end. I was virtually at the end, right? So finally he admitted 3 offences of taking indecent pictures of a girl between 2012 and 2018. And then he only spent 1 night in custody. I think it was because he claimed to be a pussy, to be fair. His case began at the Crown. His case began at the Crown Court on Wednesday this week when Judge Ian Lowry, QC, he's Scottish, him, Ian Lowry, you know, I'm ashamed to say that he's the same species as me. When Judge Ian Lowry, QC, heard the facts before adjourning overnight and remanding Nichols in custody to reflect on his past and future. Now, when a judge puts somebody in the cells to reflect, generally they do this to, like, I don't know, if they're like 12 or 14. What they don't do is get somebody that's like, you know, head of security in GCHQ and go, oh, we're going to give you some time to reflect. Nah, that doesn't happen. You know what happens? You know that police officer that killed that woman had his head caved in by other police officers while he was in the cells, and that was his time of reflection.
Yeah.
You know, that's what should have been happening to this lad. Not like, oh, we'll treat you like you're 12, you've got special needs, go in there and think about what you've done. You don't want to go to prison, do you? Oh, you've learnt your lesson, bye-bye. Yeah. You know what I mean? His case began at the Crown Court on Wednesday, reflect on his past and future. Yesterday...
You know what they've done? Yeah. They've remotely muted my mic.
Have they?
This was on Blue.
Okay, well, we'll work that out. Yesterday concluded the case and heard that Nichols had found his night in prison. Terrible.
Terrible.
The judge then allowed Nichols to walk free from court with a 3-year community order and an order to pay a total of 20,000 compensation to the 4 voyeurism victims, 5,000 each. So hang on, 5,000 quid lasts about a year. You know, so if you're a victim of sexual abuse, I doubt 5,000 quid is really good, is it? What are you going to do? Be happy for a month? Yeah, you could spend 5 grand in 5 days if you really put your mind to it, you know? Let's see, blah, 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 blah. What was I going to say a minute ago? I was actually going to say something. You asked me something.
Huh?
You asked me something a minute ago.
I didn't.
You didn't?
No.
Oh yeah, three-year community order. Which means he's doing community service, didn't it?
Yeah.
For 3 years.
No, community order, it would have said community service. Community order is, isn't it just like a slap on the wrist?
No, that's a suspended sentence.
Okay.
A community order, I'm sure, is doing work within the community.
Okay. Yeah.
Right, for 3 years. But what community would want a paedophile doing work?
Yeah.
You know, maybe a house robber, right?
Yeah.
You know, or a vandalizer or an arsonist, but not a paedophile. You know, even a murderer, right, is okay. But a paedophile, not a hope in hell. Not a hope in hell, right? If you've got kids running about, do you want them doing your patio?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The lad to be installing secret cameras and everything. So what, we're cutting it out now?
Well, you know, they actually remotely stopped my video.
Yeah, well, I should have it on mine, should I?
Did you record the...
Mine's is meant to be protected.
We're pretty known, aren't we?
Yeah, Spider and Dipsy. Shout out. Little shout out off the plod, isn't it?